The initial velocity is u, and let it strike here at point A. In such problems, look at the impact point. Wherever coefficient of restitution is given, here it is given as 0.5, look at the impact point carefully. So this is the impact point, so it is relevant for me. Then also look at the center of mass of both the rods. Its center of mass is here, its center of mass is here. That is point number one. Then try it information. So I take this point as a point for conservation of angular momentum, and let us now start the problem. So after collision, let this be the velocity of this rod, and always mark the velocity at the center of mass. Important point, when you take the translational motion, just don't write velocity at any other place. Write only at the center of mass. So let its velocity be v, and its velocity of the rod, this rod, be u dash. That is before impact, it is after impact, its velocity is v, and let it get certain angular as omega. Now we have plotted the main information variables. Look at this point of impact. You are given coefficient of restitution as 0.5, means velocity of separation, v separation upon v approach is 0.5, and apply this always at the point of impact. This is the point of impact, and apply coefficient restitution only along a particular direction. Here apply along x-axis. Now what is the velocity of approach? Velocity of approach is u minus zero. It is stationary. What is the velocity of separation? Velocity of separation will be absolute velocity of point A, this point A. We are talking about the points, not the center of mass as far as restitution is concerned. Velocity of point A minus velocity of this body at this point. If this is point A, and let this be point B. As far as velocity of point B is concerned, it's moving horizontally, it remains u dash. But velocity of point A, don't take v as the velocity of point A, because this is the velocity of center of mass. Now if you look at the motion of rod, its center of mass is moving with one velocity. It is having angular velocity omega. So point A has a relative velocity with respect to center of mass. So VA with respect to center of mass is equal to omega L upon 2. So velocity of absolute velocity of A is equal to velocity of center of mass, which is here taken as V, plus the relative velocity VA center of mass. So VA is equal to V plus omega L upon 2. And be careful about the directions also. Now put this information in this formula. So you get 1 upon 2 is equal to velocity of separation is V plus omega L upon 2 minus U dash upon U. So you get U is equal to twice V plus omega L minus twice U dash. I have got one equation. Now simply apply the conservation of linear momentum, and when you conserve the linear momentum, you take the velocities of the center of mass. Masses of both rods are given as m and m. So initial momentum is mu, final momentum is mu dash, plus linear momentum in this rod is mv. So simple equation is u is equal to u dash plus v. A very simple form of equation has come. So this is my second equation. Now look at the angular momentum about this point, center of mass. And be careful about the rotation direction in such cases. Here this rod is, if this is the center of mass, this rod is moving like this. And the distance of normal distance of velocity, always take the normal distance, is L upon 2. And it will be anti-clockwise about this point. So you take, if you take anti-clockwise at the reference, take everything as anti-clockwise and put the sign. If you take clockwise, so one reference point has to be there. Let me take anti-clockwise as the reference point. Doesn't make any difference. I can take clockwise also. If I take anti-clockwise as the reference, my angular momentum about the center of mass is mu L upon 2. Since it is anti-clockwise and I have taken anti-clockwise as positive, so I take as positive, is equal to, after collision also it is anti-clockwise, but only difference is u dash into L upon 2. Now this is also anti-clockwise. And this is m L square upon 12. Take moment of inertia, be careful about the center of mass into omega. So your another equation is u upon 2 is equal to u dash upon 2 plus L omega upon 12. Or you write u is equal to u dash plus L omega upon 6. So this is your third equation. Now use these three equations. From these two equations, I easily get as V is equal to, if you equate these are equal, so V is equal to omega L upon 6. So one value relationship I have got. Now use this equation. U dash plus V will be equal to, using these two equations, twice V plus omega L minus twice U dash. So I get 3 U dash is equal to V plus omega L. I get this equation if it's correct. So 3 U dash is equal to, what is the value of V? Is omega L upon 6. So it is 7 omega L upon 6. So U dash is 7 omega L upon 18. This is the value of U dash. Now I can find the relationship of omega L in terms of U using this equation. U is equal to U dash, which is 7 omega L upon 18, plus V, which is omega L upon 6. I can multiply by 3 and make it 18. So U is 10 omega L upon 18, or my omega is 18 U upon 10 L. So I've got the answer, I've got the omega. Once you have got the value of omega, you have got the value of omega L, which is 18 U upon 10. Now put it here, you get the value of U dash as 7 upon 18 into 18 upon 10 U. You get it as 0.7 U as U dash. And you can find the value of V also. V is omega L upon 6. So 1 upon 6 into 10 U upon 18 U upon 10, 3. So it is 0.3 U. So these are your answers. And it's very simple. Just follow step by step. Just think about the problem. What is given in the problem? Why it is given, and then how to use it. All these are the issues in physics numericals.